Hi all, welcome to my channel, welcome to my world, this is the world away. Now as promised, today I'm going to show you something that you probably didn't realise you need. I need it definitely in the workshop, especially if you've got your keyboard and computer in the same workspace as your model station. Because you've got the problem with your keyboard getting absolutely filthy from solvents, from paint, from dust, from debris from your models and stuff like that. In fact, look at my one here, it is in a complete mess. Now that's why I was thrilled when the folks over at MechDIY got in touch with me, so with some of the products that they sell on their website. They've actually sent me a mechanical keyboard, and this is what the caps look like for it. I'm going to actually put this together for you and show you how easy that is to do. Now the advantage of having a mechanical keyboard is you can change the caps to whatever you like, and I'm going to show you what that looks like now. So once you've actually done the basics of the keyboard, just check out some of the actual caps that you can get. I love the typewriter ones. I love the whole steampunk element for it. And the advantage is that once you've got this, you don't have to keep them. You can actually pop the keys off and then put another one in, which is why, as I said, for the model building community, if you have got your computer in the same space as your workstation, then it's so easy to actually have a final and clean keyboard. Because every time I look at this keyboard that I'm using at the moment, I mean, you can't see it now, I'm depressed. The shift keys lost all the text on it. Oh, it's in a complete mess. But having the advantage of just being able to swap this out whenever I need to, and if the color doesn't suit me one day, I can change it again to another day. So the possibilities are endless. But building your own keyboard isn't bad at all. All you need is some cherry switches, which are these. These come in a little jar here, and they look just like that. Let me show you on the close-up camera. These are in a tin. So quite a little novel design this is. If I take it off, as you can see, they're open. This one I haven't opened. See, you got to pull it like a tin, which is quite fun. I'm going to show you how we install those into the keyboard. You'll also need the caps, which look like this for this one. These are the ones that Sterling Kit has sent me. They've got the same sort of color scheme as the Incredible Hulk. Now you can get two lots of caps, one for the single keyboard here, and you can also get ones which have got the number pad and stuff on as well, depending on what keyboard you're used to using. And then finally, you just need the bare bones keyboard. This is what we're going to be attaching the cherry switches for and then putting the caps on. I'm going to show you how easy that is to do right now. So let's show you what you get in the basic keyboard at the moment. Now this is all metal. It's quite heavy as well, and it looks just like that. Actually, without any keycaps, the quality of this is really good. But what we've got, as you can see, we've got some keycaps in here. I've already put one in. I'm going to show you how we put those in. You also get some lifters for the base there, so you can lift up the backs here. And you've also got some little sticky pads so you don't mark your keyboard area. And you've also got the USB cable here, which is going to link that to the PC. So to make a keyboard, it's dead simple. You've got these switches. Now these are cherry switches. As you can see, they've got two poles on the bottom here. They've got a round section. This is the side that goes into the keyboard, and the caps will go on this side here. And you can only put them in one way because the two poles on this side are going to match the poles that we've got in there. So quite simply, all you do is line these up like this. And when they're in place, you just push them in like that. And I'm going to repeat that for every single one on this keyboard. So it's half time. We're going to open the other tin, just like that. Take out the silica gel, and we will continue. Did you like my OCD there of doing them in order? Let's do this. And there we go. That's all the switches in. Now, when you put them in, as you can see, those two poles there, it is easier to put the poles in first, then push the tops down. That's how I've been doing it. Now, these, as you can see here, are yellow coloured, but all the switches you can get in all the different colours under the sun. But we've got yellow here. So once we've done that, all we've got to do is put the caps on. As I said, the caps for this keyboard are already laid out here. And on the top here, we've got the main design, and then we've got the extended keyboard just over the other side. We won't be using all of these because we haven't got the full size keyboard here, but it's just a case of putting these into place. So quite simply, all we do, take one of the keys out like this. And as you can see on the back of it, you've actually got a cross pattern. And it's just a case of pushing that over the top of the cap. Just like that, as you can see. And then we can continue that through all the other caps. So once again, in super high speed mode, let's go and put these all on. So there we go, that's all the keys in. We've just built our own keyboard. Obviously that's empty. Let's just do this number pad here. I say number pad, it's not the number pad, it's the print screens, the insert, delete keys, all that sort of thing there. But I'll do this in normal time so you can just see how quick this actually is. So you see what I mean about the Hulk color scheme now, don't you? Very good. But yeah, it's that easy to do this. Just put them in, push them down. You don't have to use the keys where they go on here. I'm just following the technique here. I mean, you have got different kinds of keys in this pack, as you see. If you want one key that says die, you've got that. You've got a little smiley faces in here. I mean, they're all really for the extended keyboard, but you get the idea of how these look. So put the last of the arrow keys in here. And then what I'm gonna do in this last one, I'm gonna show you what happens. Say I put in one of these keys here, which has got a pattern on. I'm just gonna put that into the last one there. And then I decide, I don't actually like that in there. They do come with a puller, so you can just put these over the keys and then pull them out again. And that's how you change the keys when you put them in the pad. So I am going to put the correct one that we're meant to have in here just in there, and we now have a complete keyboard. Now don't be scared of the next section. I'm going to use my glasses for here. We're going to solder these switches into place. So I've got some solder with some flux and a soldering iron. This is really easy, trust me. If you've never used a soldering iron before, it's really easy. I'm going to show you what to do. Now I've zoomed right up here, and all you've got to do is you can see these pins from the switches through on this side of the circuit board here. And all you do is you're just going to hold your soldering iron to the pin just for a second, put the solder down and let it drip onto the key just like that. And you've, by the time you've done all of these, I'm speaking quietly now because I'm aware the microphone's near my mouth, then it shouldn't take too long. You will be an expert solderer. Just like that. And repeat that through the whole lot. And when you've completed all of that soldering, this is what it should look like. So on the bottom here, as you can see, you've got the spaces for the tabs. What we need to secure this down, making sure that cable's in, put that over the top. And then we've got some tiny screws here. See what I mean about like being a part work build, this is. So we'll just screw this into these points here. So that's 1, 2, 3, and 4. So that back's fully in place now. Just so you know, the connection to the computer is a USB-C to USB cable, just a normal USB cable. We've got these little adhesive tabs here. Now you can have these on all four if you wanted to. They just go over the screw holes there. So one there, and I'll put one in the other side. Now, it's up to you whether you have your keyboard lifted. If you just want it flat, you can actually use the other two here and put them in here, or you can put the magnet into this, put some of this tape on, and this is magnetic, as you can see, and that will fit over the top of this like that. So it's entirely up to you if you want them lifted or not. So what I think I'm going to do is I'm just going to reinforce the magnet by gluing that in here, making sure it's the right way round. So just got to check which way is sticking to the... Oops. Fun with magnets, huh? So they're in there. And then quite simply, these are just going to magnetize over those sections. So as you can see, just like that. One and two. So that is the keyboard completed. So if I get this connected to my PC, plug in the USB-C end onto the other side here, the computer is going to identify the keyboard. And as you can see, if I type "the quick brown fox jumps over the lazy dog," it works fine, albeit that I can't spell properly. But absolutely brilliant. And that's a mechanical keyboard for you. So and I can change those keycaps to whatever I want. As I said, I do love those steampunk typewriter ones. They look pretty cool. So I hope that's given you a insight into the mechanical keyboard. Now, if you want to get one of these yourself, once again, I'll put the link in the video description to the MechDIY site, and you can get all plethora of these, and there is quite a few over there for you to have a look at. Also, if you use promo code Wayne, I do believe you get 10% off. I'm not sure how long that lasts, but you can get 10% off using that promo code. Once again, that's all in the video description. But I really do hope you like that video. If you did, please remember to give me a thumbs up, and if you haven't subscribed already, please remember to subscribe. Other than that, take care.